Welcome to a series of videos designed to help you get the most out of Final Draft. In this tutorial, we're using a Mac, but we'll show you the Windows menus if they're different. Our focus is on using the beatboard. The beatboard is used to plan scenes, sequences, plot, and act structure for a feature film, an episode or season of a show, or even an entire series. Found under View, Beatboard, the beatboard allows you to create beats and structure points that can be placed anywhere and rearranged freely. Those beats and structure points can then be arranged on the story map and easily referenced throughout the writing process. Command plus return for Mac, Control plus enter on Windows, or simply double-clicking anywhere on the board creates a beat, which can be anything you want. An idea for a scene, story point, plot twist, a character backstory, an important reveal, or any element you think the story needs. You can also drag an image onto the beatboard to create a beat. Or copy text from a scene and drag it over to create a beat that preserves the script formatting of the text. Once you create a beat, you'll find the cursor is already in the title field ready to be filled out. Upon entering a title, Tab will move the cursor into the body of the beat box for further detail. You can style the fonts inside your beat. Use Format, Set Font, or keystrokes like Command plus I for italics. Beats can also be color-coded. Highlight one or more beats by clicking and dragging around the boxes to select them. Control-clicking on Mac and right-click on Windows opens a list of colors from which to select. At the bottom of the list is a Custom Colors option, which brings up multiple options for creating colors. Assign colors to your A, B, or C story, scenes with a certain character in them, a location, or any group of related beats. In this example, all of Trisha's character notes are lime green. With the beat still highlighted, they can be moved around the board together without losing their related positions. Clicking and dragging the edges of a beat box reshapes and resizes it. Beats will snap to the grid by default. You can turn this function off under Format, Beatboard, Grid Snapping. Highlight to select a group of beats, then Control plus click to align them in a row, a column, or to cascade them. Drag a beat to a place on the story map to associate it with a particular page in your script. The marker will be the color of your beat if you assign one, and if you hover over it, you'll see whatever is inside that beat in either the beatboard or script view. In addition to beats, structure points can be added to the beatboard. Structure points are helpful for indicating beginning and end points of sequences, act breaks, or major story or plot milestones. Like beats, structure points have a title and a body. They can also be moved, aligned, color-coded, formatted, and reshaped. Structure points stand out on the beatboard by having a thicker border. When linked to the story map by dragging from the beatboard, they're displayed as a square above the page numbers. Hovering over the square will display the structure point's title and body content. Double-clicking jumps you to the structure point on the beatboard. The squares can be dragged around the story map if you need to adjust the page goal. Content in both beats and structure points can be copied over to the script file. If you copy a beat with an image or text with formatting to your script, the image and text will both retain their format in the script file. You can adjust the size of the image in your script file, and the beatboard image will remain the same. If you adjust the size of the image in the beatboard, the image in your script will remain the same. When working on the beatboard, you can adjust the screen to night mode by clicking the moon in the lower right corner. Zoom in or zoom out using the zoom slider. You can export your beatboard to PDF for easy sharing. Now you know the basics of using the beatboard. Be sure to watch our video on using the story map to learn how these two powerful tools interact. If you have any comments or suggestions, we want to hear them. Just go to Help, Submit Feedback, and let us know what you think. If you need technical support, go to Help, Get Support for access to Final Draft resources, including email, chat, and phone services. To watch more helpful video tutorials, visit the Final Draft YouTube channel at youtube.com/FinalDraftInc. Final Draft, the industry standard screenwriting software.